Please welcome Oddbot.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, good afternoon. My name is Martijn Lukaert. I am the founder and CEO of Oddbot. With Oddbot, we are accelerating the transition to sustainable agriculture. We do so by first focusing on the organic farmers to help them with their manual weeding, to then focus on the conventional chemical farmers and offer them a sustainable alternative to the full field spraying, which is still most common method to manage the weeds. Here you see how it's currently being done in organic farming. So people are laying on these weeding beds head first to do the picking, and it's very challenging to find stuff, to motivate them, and it's getting more and more costly. Also, the conventional farmers have a big challenge because the amount of chemicals they are allowed to use on the field, it's further reduced because the use of these chemicals is under heavy scrutiny. And you see that Europe is investing heavily to double the amount of organic farmland within a decade and reduce the amount of chemicals that are currently being used by half. And last but not least, the customers, the consumers, they also demand healthy, affordable, nutritious food that is ethically sourced. And that's where we come in. We make impact on 7 of the sustainable development goals, and we have this autonomous mechanical weeding robot that can work day and night. Indeed, as Letitia said, distinguish the weeds from the crops and remove them with a 3-in-1 gripper that I will show in a second. And that's also the progress that we have made since the rounds we had previously. We have a robot now in the field at the farmers, and they are testing it right now. Where we differentiate the most is really in the high precision. So the system is configured in a way that we can optimize the hand and eye coordination. So at the moment of the detection, we already decide how we are going to remove the weeds. And therefore, our solution is most optimal to work in high density, high value crops. Here you see how the detection algorithm is performing. We've now put this the camera system into enclosure with artificial lighting. And we have also added an extra layer in this neural network, so we can now also detect the stems to properly remove the weeds and get closer to the crops. The business model is currently being validated with the farmers, whereby we start with the weeding as a service, so we are like a cleaning agency, keeping the fields clean as a contract worker. Then we want to move into the robots as a service. Currently, these farmers, they spend over 100 hours per hectare to keep the field clean. So initially, this is where we focus on, really help them with the manual weeding. This is a bit about our journey so far. In 2018, we have started to build the first proof of principle. In 2019, we got our first funding from a proof of concept fund. We are now utilizing the field, the farm of the future, where we collaborate with Kubota and Wageningen Research, where they help us to offer our the fields where we can continue the tests. A bit about the team. We work with Erik, also from this Eindhoven region. He was working on the Sarescon, the asparagus harvesting robot. We have Wouter, the AI lead, and Dirk, who's coming from Lely, the robot milking system supplier. And I myself, I'm a serial tech entrepreneur. And a bit about the background where Oddbot started. Initially, I wanted to develop an on-demand delivery robot. We made a bit of a pivot to the agriculture because it was not yet feasible to put these robots on the sidewalks. And here you see how I envision the future for the robots to be. So eventually, we put out a swarm of these robots on the field, which can communicate properly with each other and also learn from each other. Here you see the system of us live, or that this was last week on the ridge of carrots. So you see a bit of the detection unit in front, and this is what we want to further optimize with the use of 5G. So we want to optimize the detection and the removal, utilizing not only the first vision box, which you see here in the front. There behind it is the robot arm, the Delta Arm robot with the gripper. This is a three-in-one system where we can push back the very small weeds back into the ground. We can open the gripper to start pulling the weeds, and if we close the gripper counterclockwise, we can start scooping. And this whole system we want to further optimize, whereby we use the second vision box as well to optimize the retraining loop, and also have a human in the loop, whereby we foresee that we can monitor the robot remotely, also control the robot remotely, and if the robot is put on the field to work autonomously, that we can connect to it and offer the remote support via teleoperation, or to be in a way that we can be telepresent. So together with the 5G hub, we really want to further develop our current minimal viable product into the future, where we have a swarm of these robots autonomously on the field. We would like to work with you guys to test out the 5G network, the optimization in the computing, whereby we also would like to see if we can work with, let's say, a swarm intelligence, have higher intelligent nodes and the lower intelligent nodes, so that we can really speed up the development together with you, with Eindhoven region, and with our partners together. So I look forward to hopefully winning this, and otherwise at least continue to collaborate together, because I really see this as the future, and the connectivity, in my opinion, is key to speed up the retraining and enable the nature to communicate its needs with robots and us humans, so we can work in a in synergy. Thank you very much.
I'm here with CFO and founder of AirCision, Betsy Lindsay. Betsy, when we think of the future of farming, how do you see robots like the Oatbot being used?
I really believe that this solution is taking, you know, our use of data to the next level. So precision farming has been around now for years, where they use satellite and GIS to give us more information about what's on the field. But I think this takes it down to the ground level and really gives farmers the information they need to you know, get the smart farming done and really use less pesticides and things like that. So I think it's a really smart solution.
Okay, and in your opinion, what is the importance of events like the 5G Hub Innovation Challenge?
Networking and connection. I think, you know, just getting your solution out there and getting the help that you need is about communicating to the ecosystem, to the community. So, yeah.
Okay. And as an experienced entrepreneur, would you share with our contestants the best piece of advice you were ever given?
I guess I've probably said this before at other events, but I think it is about performance to plan. So basically, if you say in a pitch that we're going to do this by this date, if you show everybody that you're going to do that and you have done it, then people start believing you and following you. So I think that's the biggest piece of advice, is just make a plan that actually is executable and deliver.
Amazing. Thank you very much, Betsy.
Yeah, of course.